Thank you. Thank you, Monica. Our scripture reading this morning is from the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verses 1 to 17. Jesus knows what is ahead of him. He knows what will happen to him. And he's preparing his disciples for life, for when he will not be with them here on earth any longer. He teaches them how to be disciples and how to be servants, and he shows that by washing their feet. He tells them not to worry. Believe in God, believe also in me. And he tells them that they will not be alone, and he promises them the Holy Spirit. And in the passage for this morning, he tells them the parable of the vine and the branches, showing that they are rooted in him. Shall we pray? Living God, as we open our scriptures, help us to hear your word to us, that we may truly understand, and that understanding we may believe, and in believing we may follow your way, seeking your honor and glory in all that we do. Amen. Hear the word of the Lord. I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word that I've spoken to you. Remain in me, as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. And apart from me, you can do nothing. If you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up, thrown into the fire and burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. This is to my Father's glory, that you bear much fruit, showing yourselves to be my disciples. As the Father has loved you, so I love you. Now remain in my love. And you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and that your joy may be complete. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if I do what I command. Yeah, I no longer call you servants, because a servant doesn't know what the master's business is. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I have learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I choose you, and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command: love each other. The word of the Lord.